Hello everyone, welcome to the System Verilog lecture. Today we will see FSM example by using construct, assertion and coverage. So let's start it. Next. So basically we see what is the FSM, that is finite state machine. FSM, it is main control block in any design. It is help design progress state to state in orderly manner to generate the respective control signal. That is, to generate any control signal, FSM is useful. FSM provides good hardware infrastructure for controlling the signal and also debugging capability, since the state of each design is useful and well defined. There are two types of FSM. First is Moore state machine and second one is Mealy state machine. In Moore state machine, the output is defined only depend on present state. But in Mealy machine, output is depend on present state as well as present input. Next is what the constructor. Here are list of constructors which are used in system Verilog, such as ended, dollar past, and interest, or first match, within, throughout. So the first match constructor we will use in the example to explain how the FSM is work. And here is one diagram is shown that there are three different state of FSM, S0, S1, and S2. How the FSM is actually work? Back. So here is a first example, the first match constructor. Whenever the timing window shows the specific sequence along the binary operator, as we are using AND or, then there is a possibility to getting multiple matches from the same clock cycle. At the same clock cycle, there is chances to match more than one sequence. So the first match is very useful that time. And it is selected the first sequence which is matched through that signal and other will be discarded. So it is very helpful while combination multiple sequences together whenever only the first match of the timing window will be accepted and throughout other part will be rejected. Next we will see the coding part. Here is a simple program, sequence S30A at the positive edge of the clock. A double slash A is to 3, B end of the sequence. Here A and B sequence is generated. The next sequence at S30B at positive clock, C slash double slash 2 to 3, D end of the sequence. Here also C and D are generated. And property P30, here is the main property will be defined to check the first match constructor, that is at the rate positive clock, first match S30A or S30B. First match jo hoil te output select honar and the end of the property. So here is a clock diagram, that clock sequence is generated, then A signal A, B, C, D, therefore signals are generated at that clock. First we will see at A and D signal, A and C signal at the second clock, A and C signal is matches, and also similarly at the clock 8, A and C also get matches. So this matching property will properly execute, that first match property will pass at shown this at clock 3, the edge so the matching property will work at clock 3 and as well as at clock 8. Next will be assertion.
The next part is assertions are used to predict the behavior of a design. You know that as like as a if else statement, assertion checks the condition or expression and also evaluate and debug the design unit or display the statements of unit. it simply checks an embedded design or a design unit during the simulation period. Next, a warning or errors are generated on the failure of a specific condition sequence of events. It means that as we want to display some warning, some error message, or successful statements, then we can do that also with assertion. There are two kinds of assertion, immediate assertion and concurrent assertion. It is one simple program which shows the immediate assertion code. In that code, clock cycle and A and B is the input to the code, and the every 5 nanosecond clock is become negated. Here the generating the signals, that is first at the positive edge of the clock, A and B is the logic 1. After 15 nanosecond, B is going to be 0. And on that, after 10 nanosecond, B is going to be 1. And A is equal to 0. After 20 nanosecond, A becomes 1. And after 10 nanosecond, both the input A and B and also the clock will be the finished. Next is the immediate assertion statement. It is said that the always at the rate positive edge of the clock assert A and then B. It means that when both the input, that is A and B, when A and B was the one, then the assert statements will be the pass. Here we see that at the first positive edge of the clock, A equals to 1 and B equals to 1. Hence the assertion statement will be the pass. And at this positive edge of the clock, A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. Hence, the assertion statement will be the pass. Rest other condition, it will be the fail. Hence, it is the clock diagram of that code. It is the simulated result, as same as the clock diagram. Next, how can I write an assertion for FSM, finite state machine? Here is one example that state A transits from state A to state B when C equals to 1 or stays in state A as long as C equals to 0. The diagram shows that when C equals to 0, state A remains in same state. And when C equals to 1, it changes its state from A to B. Here is the code AP A to B. It is the variable whatever we can label. Assert property. At the rate positive edge of the clock, state equals to A and percent C implies that state equals to B. It means that here we use the non-overlapping implication. When the antecedent is equal to the consequent, then we want to evaluate signal on next clock cycle. Hence, here we use the non-overlapping implication. Here, state equals to A and C is the antecedent, and state equals to B is a consequent. When this condition is passed, then it implies that it changes state A to B. It means that when C equals to 1, and if the state is in A state, then it changes from A to B. And second one is assert property at the rate positive edge of the clock, state equals to A and negation or not of the C. It implies state equals to A or dollar state, stable state. Stable state means it stays in same state. State equals to A hash zero. Here we use the double and instead of that, we can use double hash also. The difference is that state equals to A double hash zero C implies meaning it means that if the state equals to A is false, that is first property or first condition when it is false, then instead of checking the second condition, it evaluated that condition is false. And when we use the and percent sign between two conditions, then it ending first these two expressions and evaluate the result. This is the example of assertion in FSM. part is a coverage.
So the FSM coverage, the FSM coverage is the part in a code coverage. Commonly, code coverage matrix include line coverage, condition coverage, toggle coverage, and FSM coverage. Now we will study what is FSM coverage. Before that, we see what is FSM actually. The information stored in these elements. These elements refers to latches or flip flop. Can be seen as the state of the system. If the system transits between finite number of such internal states, then FSM can be used to design the system. Mainly, FSM have a finite number of state as well as condition. The conditions refers to ours means coverage of condition that leads to internal state transition and the relevant behavior of design of each machine state. Mainly that FSM coverage is checked by second is the states arc coverage. Provide complete verification of a FSM model behavior. Next. Then the first method is cover directives. Cover directive method is based on the assertion based method, a verification method. In this technique, FSM arcs are first defined using system Verilog assertion property using any of constructs, construct that allow temporal expression description. We will see we uses the cover directives to check for a coverage of this defined properties and eventually checking of FSM arc coverage result. And this is used in this method to define properties which express all different arcs of a machine. See that EMD5 means there may be one arc occur from standby to sleep, and the CMD consists of the value of 5. The property uses non-overlapping implication operator to describe the state transition. The antecedent expression means the expression before that. Property describes one arc in a state machine. The number of property required to describe the complete space of arcs in the state machine is equal to the actual number of arcs between all adjacent states of the state machine. Means that there are two variables, standby and sleep, complete the one arc from standby to sleep. It calculated by this property. Next. So second method is cover group. This cover group method is usually uses the functional coverage construct for system Verilog. Cover group and the cover points are defined to cover both state transition and the corresponding conditions value that causes this transition. The state transition means suppose take the example of flip flop or latches that stores some particular information, suppose 0 to 1, 1 to 0, how much transitions it takes. That refers to state transition. And the arcs means the coverage of condition. condition, how many conditions it covers, that checked by that arc. Then the arc coverage is defined by the cross coverage of this cover point defined earlier. The cover group construct is built by defining one or more cover points as well as one or more cross coverage targets between the cover point. See, there are three points. First, the transfer, standby, and sleep. Means there are two arc from transfer to standby and standby to sleep. When the command CMD is in between 11 to 22, then it is in the transfer to standby. And when the CMD is in between 1 to 11, then it is in the standby to sleep. Next. The implication of arc coverage model for this state machine uses the cover directory methods, requires a cover group declaration with two cover points and one cross. And this is the syntax of a cover group method, state cover point state, and base is the variable which is used in such a this is standby to sleep. Standby to sleep, it indicates the transition of standby to sleep. Then means transfer to standby, and it equal to the transition between transfer to standby. Basically, FSM coverage measures how many FSM states have been visited or how many transitions occur during that verification. For this purpose, these two methods are very important. Thank you.